Hi guys, welcome. This is Kieran from the One Zen Academy and One Zen Wellness. Hope this finds you well. So I'm just going to take you through some different types of breath work. The first type of breath work is the Wim Hof breath work. If you've watched videos previous, you know I'm a big fan of this. So the Wim Hof breath work temporarily stimulates your sympathetic nervous system, which is a fight or flight response. And the reason why we do this primarily is to tolerate more and more carbon dioxide in the blood. And we know in everyday life, people who don't breathe properly have higher amounts of carbon dioxide, and this has been shown in certain studies to induce a state of anxiety, panic attacks, and long-term depression, because we need more and more oxygen, but we are able to use it less and less. So what we're trying to do with the Wim Hof breath work is to, not temporarily, but almost like an ongoing training, to tolerate higher amounts of carbon dioxide. And what this does is it slows your breath down for the rest of the day and allows you to focus and take control of your faculties better. And that's just what I've noticed in my own practice. So we're gonna do that first, and then straight after, I'm gonna bring it back down. So almost like a training session, like a warm up and cool down. So I'm gonna do alternative nostril breathing. And the alternative nostril breathing is gonna be fairly slow and deep. And it's designed primarily to bring you back down. So it's to stimulate your parasympathetic, relax and digest response. And we'll lower blood pressure, my heart rate will lower as well because of this. And getting the best of both will allow me to really focus, especially with clients. So when I do my massage clients, or when I'm doing personal training and more the holistic breath work, this allows me to really focus my energy on my client. And allows me to basically crack on with the day. So we'll do the Wim Hof breath work first. So we're gonna do three rounds, and in each round it's gonna be 30 breaths. So you'll see me counting on my fingers, because I'll get completely sucked in and I'll lose count. So I'm gonna count on my fingers around 30 breaths. If it's 28 or 32, it doesn't really matter, to be fair. And then it's gonna be, we're gonna, at the end of that first round, I'm gonna push out all the air. We're gonna try and do that for as long as we can, and then draw in air. Do that for about 15 seconds, and then we start the second round. So we're gonna do three rounds of that, and then we're gonna do alternative nostril breathing. And alternative nostril breathing, you can do it lying down or sitting up. So for the Wim Hof, I'm gonna lie down. For the alternative nostril breathing, I'm gonna sit up and make sure that your posture's nice and upright. Okay, are you with me? I hope so. I hope you're not just turning it off willy-nilly. So we lie down. So with the Wim Hof breath work, you can breathe in through your mouth or nose. You're going to expand your stomach, then rib cage, and then clavicle. So imagine the noise you're going to make is as if you're blowing up a balloon. Okay, so get into a nice relaxed position, and here we go. First round. So that's three rounds of the Wim Hof breath work. If you can exhale and hold your breath for longer, then please do so. The idea is to hold as long as possible. At the moment, I'm only averaging maybe between 45 seconds to a minute, depending on how lack of sleep I've had due to children keeping me up all night. But hey, man, that's cool. That's why we have kids, right? So as well as that, so you tolerate higher amounts of carbon dioxide, you'll get a lot of tingling, you'll feel quite good afterwards as well. So after that, you'll feel quite buzzing with energy. And if you want kind of an alert, awakened but relaxed sensation, then do the alternative breath work afterwards, and it will give you a real sense of grounding and a real kind of focus throughout the day. And this is just my own experience, what I found. So make sure you can sit nice and upright. If you can't sit cross-legged and upright, get a bolster or something under your bum that just lifts your hips slightly like that. So I'll just go through 30 odd breaths for the alternative nostril breathing. You'll need your thumb and that finger there, like that. And in a lot of yogic texts, it will say place a finger on your third eye. For the purpose of this, you can do that, but it's not a requirement of what we're trying to stimulate. So I would normally do this if I was doing this more for a spiritual focus sense practice. But for the purpose of this, it's just to relax the heart rate, reduce blood pressure, and this does reduce blood pressure. You'll see in another video that I'm going to release on YouTube on this channel, where I will put the test. I'll have a blood pressure cuff on and I'll show you exactly how much it can bring the blood pressure down, and I'll show you exactly how dysfunctional breathing can increase blood pressure. So obviously that's for a later time, coming soon. So thumb and finger. So you'll only swap nostrils on the exhale, okay? So you'll breathe in, big belly breath, swap, breathe out, and then in through that nostril, swap, because remember you only swap on the exhale. Okay, so try and do what you can. So we're gonna go from 30 breaths, nice and slow, nice and controlled. Okay, are you with me? Swap. Swap.